us here at Texas Football Today, I don't think it's really any secret that we're kind of football nerds. We like all things football memorabilia, and so when we had the opportunity to get in and talk a little sports memorabilia, we jumped at the chance. And here to talk a little bit about what they've got going on at Panini America is Tracy Hackler. Tracy, what's your official title there at Panini?
Marketing manager.
Okay. Got it, marketing manager. So for those who don't know, maybe they haven't heard the name Panini, or they're thinking of the sandwich.
Right.
What, I'm sure you get that a lot.
We do.
What, tell us, like, what is Panini? What is this company? What do you guys do?
Well, the short answer is Panini America is the world's largest licensed sports and entertainment collectibles company.
Okay.
Global, subsidiaries all over the world, but in North America, we specialize really in sports, mm-hmm. trading cards, and memorabilia. And we have exclusive licenses with the NBA, the NFL, and the NFLPA, NASCAR, FIFA World Cup.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're kind of the official trading card of college sports.
Yeah, because you guys, because I heard something before this about how, you know, you say Panini America, a lot of the business you guys do worldwide is soccer, right?
Absolutely.
That's one of the things you guys do.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's where their roots are in Europe overseas, mm-hmm. is World Cup stickers and just soccer stickers. So when Panini America came into being in North America, they landed the NBA license exclusively and kind of shocked a lot of people in the States, because a lot of those people knew Panini only as a sticker manufacturer for soccer. And that's a phenomenally successful business still today, but in North America, obviously, we specialize in kind of the big four or five.
Yeah, and obviously, football is king around here. And I'll be honest, like, growing up, I was a baseball card guy. I was a baseball card collector. You know, my dad would bring me home a pack. I'd crack it open, and I'm sure bend them and ruin them all together. But the football card, you got a ton of football cards here. The football cards industry is booming. It's exploding right now, right?
Yeah, it's doing really well. I mean, as is so often the case in any sport, the rookies drive the business. Mm-hmm. And when you're coming off a rookie season like last year, where you had Dak Prescott, yeah. and Ezekiel Elliott, Carson Wentz, and then rolling into this year where guys seemingly every week are popping up and performing, Alvin Kamara and Kareem Hunt and so many guys. So we're driven by the success of a rookie class in any given sport. But to your point, the trading card collecting has changed so much, and it's some of the stuff I brought you as we show them off. You'll see, I mean, there's cards with diamonds, autograph cards with pieces of game worn memorabilia. It runs the gamut.
Yeah, because like I'm looking at this. So, for example, we got these boxes here, like for Texas A&M, and I would never think about like Texas A&M cards. But when you buy this 80 collegiate trading cards, you know, you got Johnny Manziel in there. So if you're an Aggie fan, you can just go nuts with your favorite team. You don't have to kind of sort through the cards and stuff.
Correct.
Like that. You can get your own individual team.
Absolutely. One of the cool things about our college team sets or box sets is that it's multi-sport.
Yeah.
So it's more than just
football.
It's basketball and baseball, and the same with TCU, Baylor, and UT. Mm-hmm. So those are kind of our individual boxes for team-specific college fans.
Because I think that, yeah, you know, when I mentioned baseball cards, you know, when I whip open a pack of cards, I was always looking for, I'm a Rangers fan, I was always looking for Rafael Palmeiro or something like that. Here, you know, if you buy the team set, then you're just getting your favorite team, which is, you know, in a lot of respects what people are going for.
Yeah, and the cool thing about the team sets as well is that there are cards honoring the Coliseums or the fields or the arenas or the logos, the mascot. So that's cool too. In the UT box, as an example, you could pull a card of Roger Clemens and Kevin Durant and Ricky Williams all within three or four cards of each other. So it really appeals to the diehard fan of that school.
We're talking with Tracy Hackler of Panini America. It's paniniamerica.com and shop.paniniamerica.com. Is that correct?
Store.paniniamerica.net and paniniamerica.net.
Yeah, it's paniniamerica.net. That's where you want to go. Christmas is coming. And if my wife, if you're listening, PaniniAmerica.net. Anyway, the other thing is, like, I think we think of baseball cards, we think of trading cards like this, like college football cards, but you guys have, like, a premium set, too, because you were showing these off beforehand, and these are out of control. The Flawless Collegiate set. Okay, explain
yes.
to me what this is.
So Flawless is our highest-end product, and we do it in the NFL, we do it on the NBA side. This is the first year we've done it on the college side, and our product development team back in the office has done a phenomenal job of building our collegiate trading card business. And we start everything. So if this is our kind of every fan kind of product.
Like me.
Well, yeah, I mean, if you like it, UT, you want that. And then we have kind of contenders draft picks and elite draft picks is kind of our tribute to the upcoming rookie class. There are also NFL veterans in there in their college uniforms. And so you go from there to something like Flawless, which is the very top end of the spectrum. It's $1,500.
Oh, my gosh.
For 10 cards. But what you might get in there are some of the legends of the game. Autographs, pieces of game-worn memorabilia, cards with diamonds in them or rubies or emeralds. And if we need to open this at some point. Or y'all need to open it and just show people what it's about because it's.
Let's just go ahead and do this. So first of all, guys, I just want to point this out. Like this is a Ricky Williams card signed by Ricky Williams, and is that part of his jersey?
That's actually part of his game worn jersey. On the back, we'll say.
Holy crap!
In the case of Dante Foreman, as an example.
Yeah.
He, when we went to production with these, we didn't have any of his game worn stuff, so we have him wear the jersey. We take it off and we cut it up and we say player worn on the back. But on the back of the Earl Campbell or the Ricky Williams example, it says game worn.
Game worn material. Oh my gosh. This is incredible.
So it's a piece of history. And then we have like a hook'em card with Earl Campbell. We have them sign inscriptions. And so.
Max, put this in your pocket. This is, yeah. Oh my gosh.
I won't tell.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, so I do want to crack this up. I'm gonna be a jerk, and I'm just gonna crack.
No, do it.
I never get to have nice things.
Well, you're gonna, your face on these will be worth it.
You're listening to live coverage of me opening this up.
He's opening a briefcase of
it's a briefcase
of flawless collegiate
Panini
football.
PaniniAmerica.net is where you can find it.
Yes.
For the football fan in your life.
Yes.
Collegiate fan in your life. All right, so it comes in. Comes in a briefcase. Here we go. Look at this thing.
That's
right,
pretty cool.
This thing open.
Yep.
It feels like Pulp Fiction. It's going to be like the goal. Be like,
grab your scissors and cut right there on the side.
Cut there on the side. This is live television, people.
It's right. Almost like Fort Knox getting in there.
It really is. Well, I can understand why. If you guys are selling them for $1,500, why would you let some... dude like me.
You're
I don't know, man.
You're a special dude.
You are overstating my importance. All right, let's see if we can crack this thing open. I think I got it enough. Let's see. Come on.
Oh, it's,
all right, I'm going to get it. I promise.
You will.
I've got coverage of me trying to open a briefcase here on Texas Football Today. Give them all the show hashtag TF Today. This is the most work I've ever done on the show.
Well, it's.
I think I got it.
All right.
All right, let's see. Yeah. All right. Open it up.
Let's see what you got.
Oh, my gosh. First of all, there's a key.
Touchdown.
Which is amazing. So you can lock it. I'm sorry. Don't lose my mic. I know. All right. So there's that. I'm sorry. I'm excited. So
you should be.
So
that's a good box.
We got a Bo Jackson card. All right. That's kind of amazing. Woo.
Look at that one.
How about a pair of Florida legends, Tim Tebow and Emmitt Smith, signed.
That's pretty sweet.
Autograph card.
Pretty sweet.
And Thomas Rawls with a, is this a diamond?
That's a diamond. So you can use that as like an engagement gift, or just put it on your...
It's a diamond!
Or your mantle.
Not to mention, and by the way, these all come with certificates of authenticity, which I know are very important in your trade.
Yes.
And then, there's a box here. Do I want to open up this box?
Absolutely.
I guess I need to.
Yeah, you got to.
We really didn't plan this, I tell you. Like, you're listening. Okay. Vince Young, a signed Vince Young card.
That.
That's a good... We got a winner. We got a player's year card. How about Juju Schuster-Smith, a game-worn, player-worn material signed.
Nice. Love it.
Let's see. All right. Brad Kaya, the quarterback for, if you remember, the quarterback from Miami. He's here. That's player-worn.
Yes.
We've also got.
Oh, look at that one.
I'm kind of running through. Oh, my gosh. All right. Corey Clement, the running back for Wisconsin. That's the Outback. Look at that. It's the Outback Bowl patch. You just get it.
He's having a great
season. This is the best thing that's ever. Another Juju Schuster-Smith, and look, that's from the San Diego Bowl, so the Poinsettia Bowl, whatever they played in. Yeah, you're on the wrong side of this thing.
I'm disappointed. There's no piece of a blooming onion in that Outback Bowl.
The Boz.
Oh,
Brian
Bosworth.
I know he's kind of not the most popular person around these parts, but
Otto. Look at that.
Got Earl Campbell autograph.
Hey,
you talked about rookies.
Yes.
What about Samaje Perine?
Yes.
This is a signed Samaje Perine card.
Also having a good season.
And wow. Okay, this is special. Of course, a great story. James Conner, the running back from Pitt.
Yeah,
and that's
cancer survivor.
That is a player-worn material there.
Very nice.
All that comes in this pack that I'm going to steal from you.
Yes.
But this is incredible.
I got to be honest. It's worth $1,500 just to watch you open it.
That is unbelievable. Oh, my gosh. Yeah, if you are looking for the gift for the football nut in your life, I will personally vouch for this. This is awesome. Oh, my gosh. This is really incredible, and it comes in the package. You can find it at paniniamerica.net. Now, I do want to ask you a little bit about maybe the card industry before
yes.
we let you go, because I know that, like, you know, as I mentioned, I'm a baseball card collector. How is overall the industry is still growing strong, and maybe because of diversification like this?
Well, diversification, we're enjoying one of our best years ever, and a lot of it has to do with the players and how they perform on the field, because as exciting. The more exciting their performances, the more it drives people to want to get a piece of that.
Mm-hmm.
And trading cards have always been a great avenue to kind of express your fandom, to get a piece of your favorite player or team. Mm-hmm. And that's what we do. So when we have strong rookie classes, like we have the most anticipated rookie class maybe of all time in the NBA this year,
yeah.
with Alonzo and Markle and Donovan Mitchell and all those guys, football has a really strong rookie class. And we're coming off a baseball season that had the likes of Aaron Judge and Cody Bellinger, those three things together, it just really drives the market and infuses so much new energy into it.
This has been my favorite interview ever. I want to do this. Let's just do this every week. Let me open a new briefcase every week.
I'm in.
It's Tracy Hackler. It's PaniniAmerica.net. It is with Christmas right around the corner. You cannot afford not to go there for the fan in your life. PaniniAmerica.net. Tracy, appreciate your time and appreciate, you know, you bringing in all these fun toys. This is pretty awesome.
Oh, this is for you guys to have fun with. I appreciate the opportunity.
Absolutely.
Microphone. That was fun.
Yeah, I think I got awesome. To appropriately freak out. And, I mean, some of that stuff was unbelievable. Like, that's the...
It was amazing.
So it's like they've got this kind of stuff, and it's like, okay, so this is like 80 A&M trading cards, right? But it's not just... And what I thought was interesting, like, it's football, too, yep. but it's like basketball as well.
Baseball, too.
Baseball as well. So I got these. But then, like... What he brought in was like the stuff I'm usually not allowed to touch, right?
Yeah,
like
and we took it away from you immediately.
Yeah, they're like, no. Okay, that's just for show. It was awesome, and yeah. I now understand how like really cool rich people live.